create an emitter from the RealFlow menu, if a previously created scene does not exist, or the RealFlow tree structure will be creating, adding the connections that are needed. Pressing the play button is enough for the simulation to begin. One of the main advantages of working with RealFlow for cinema is that we can make changes in real time, affecting our simulation. This way we can add demons, or change the parameters and see how the simulation changes without needing to re-simulate. For example, we could change the type of emitter in simulation time and see how it behaves as of this moment. All the elements of the RealFlow structure, such as demons, meshes, or other emitters, will act on the new system that we are changing. Within the scene node, we have the parameters with a level of stability of different fluid solvers, such as the steps, as well as the option to cache the fluid and where the information will be saved. Furthermore, regardless of the type or types of emitters we have in the simulation, the fluid node contains all the information concerning the level of the type of solver to use in the simulation. These could be SPH, PBD, or DUM, and down the line, new solvers will be included too. Another one of the major advantages of working with RealFlow inside cinema is that we can make transformations of the emitters, move them, rotate them, or scale them, and the fluid will automatically adjust to the new transformation. Increasing the value of the resolution in the parameters of the fluid, we will be able to increase the number of particles in the simulation. The RealFlow plugin for cinema adjusts to the needs of the cinema users, allowing the use of objects and tools belonging to cinema to be used within the RealFlow emitters, which could be the splines. Taking into account the transformations of the nodes for RealFlow or cinema, we will be able to generate and to position the emitters wherever it is necessary. The method of connecting the nodes between RealFlow and cinema is quite simple. We only need to drag the objects that we want to use with the parameters of the emitter, and this will be adjusted to the new object introduced. And as we previously said, all the structure generated by RealFlow will also affect the new particles that are being created. Once we have our simulation, the mesh inside RealFlow for Cinema 4D is quite simple. Adding a mesher node, the particles will mesh in simulation time with the parameters we have set up for it.